Hello from the Bureau. I'm climatologist Robin Duell.
And I'm hydrologist Paul Fakemer, and we're here to discuss the climate water outlook for spring. Although we've seen some recent significant rainfall, particularly along the east coast and the central parts, it's been relatively dry across much of the country this winter. And while we've seen a recent increase in soil moisture as a result of that rain, the landscape in many southern regions remains relatively dry. So what can we expect for rainfall as we head into spring, Robin?
Well, we're actually seeing a very strong signal that spring is likely to be wetter than average for the eastern two-thirds of the country, a greater than 80% chance. In the west, though, the outlook is more neutral to drier than average.
So what's driving such a strong outlook for that rainfall in the east?
At the moment, the ocean in the central Pacific is cooling, and at that same time, the ocean is warming to the north of Australia. This means there's a chance that La Nina may develop in the coming months. And for Australia, La Nina is typically associated with wetter than normal springs in the eastern half of the country, with an increased chance of widespread flooding as well. And this is having quite a strong influence on our rainfall outlook at the moment. As well, in the Indian Ocean, we're also seeing some warming near northern Australia, which could be the sign of a developing negative Indian Ocean dipole, or IOD. A negative IOD, like La Nina, also typically increases the chance of a wetter than usual spring and widespread flooding across parts of Australia. So what does this expected rainfall mean for stream flows, Paul?
Well, still low and near median stream flows are more likely at over 80% of locations for August to October. The high flows that we're expecting are mainly in the southeast regions where there's a relatively wetter landscape due to previous rainfall. Hopefully, we'll continue to see good inflows in those areas into water storages, including in the Murray-Darling Basin, where storage levels are still relatively low. So, Robin, what can we expect for springtime temperatures?
Daytime temperatures are likely to be cooler than average, where that chance of rainfall is high, with cloud reducing the amount of spring sunshine we're expecting. Elsewhere, warmer days remain likely due to those warmer ocean temperatures around us. At night time, though, that extra cloud acts as a blanket. So this combined with those warm oceans means nights are likely to be warmer than average over most of Australia this spring. It's still spring, though, so it will be cold at times in the south. But at night, it's likely to be relatively warmer than in other years, which means we can also expect fewer frost days than usual this spring.
Thanks, Robin. That's it from us for now. Please head over to our website for more information or join us for our next update at the end of the month.